Hi, my name is Dean, and welcome to Daily Dose of Reddit, your daily dose of r/askmeanything. I am a 100-year-old human and a World War II veteran. I want to share my life and experiences with people who might be helped by them. Ask me anything. Greetings. As you may have imagined, the person typing and facilitating this AMA is not the 100-year-old human, but his granddaughter, me. A little bit about my grandpa. He grew up in Washington State and has traveled quite a bit. He worked for the FDA for many years, some as an investigator, some as a pharmacist. He served in the Air Force during World War II as a photographer. Clearly, there's more to him than this, so ask him some questions. Proof. Here is how the gentleman looked like in the time of writing the AMA post. Has reaching 10 decades giving you any new insight? The world is a mess. I may want to modify that answer later. What was the most tense moment of your life? When I stepped forward to get married. No kidding, just briefly, I thought I was gonna faint when the pastor asked those questions. By the way guys, if you're enjoying this video so far, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. It will help us out quite a bit. And if you don't enjoy the videos in the future anymore, you can always unsubscribe. Let's get back to the video. My great-grandmother lived to 108, and she told the best stories about life and learning. What is one thing you'd like to share with younger generations? Just use common sense. Most shocking thing you photographed in World War II that you did not expect? Let's not put it on what I photographed. In Normandy, of all the areas the photo planes did, was the total area that they put into pictures that ended up in something like 10,000 total prints. Well, that's something later on, he says. Living 100 years, what was the biggest leap of technology that you've experienced? What seemed the most unreal when it came out? The artillery guns and others were equipped with equipment that could detect when other objects were nearby and go off even though it had not been aimed at. That technology was used also for ground fire. There was a time during the Pacific part of the war that U.S. forces did not know where the Japanese fleet was. The CO of the 8th Photo, which was also in my general area, was flying on a photo mission and saw the Japanese fleet. He hightailed his way home, squawking on his radio. The radios were good for 35 miles. That resulted in a U.S. Navy dealing with the Japanese fleet, both air and navy. I recently came across a shoebox full of letters that my great-grandparents wrote to each other during World War II. Did you have anyone you were writing sweetheart letters to? For general letters, just a few people I met in the service, Air Force. For sweetheart, there was a girl in study hall, every other seat in the auditorium. I liked her very much. She had a Spanish book. I looked to the other side of me. Another girl had a dictionary. I used her dictionary to write to the first one. She thought I knew Spanish, but I didn't. She was mad at me. What was his favorite plane that he got to photograph? World War II or anything afterwards? And thank you for your service, sir. P-38 fighter, photo. The fighter aircraft was used mainly in Europe area. The photo area was used to take the guns out, put in two or three sets of cameras, and the prints, negatives that were produced were 18 inches wide and 9 inches deep. Most of those photos were made around 20,000 feet, so that gives you the scale for how you want to measure it. The P-38 was used somewhat in the Pacific. The P-38 was an escort for the bombers, but it was mainly recognized as a fighter plane. But around Europe, big river there, they put 150 and 300-pound bombs and made them into bombers. Because the Germans would look up, oh, they're just taking photos, and kaboom. I have two questions that I would love to hear the perspective of an aged gentleman on. One, what was it like when you learned of the atomic bomb? This is such a huge turning point in human history that I can't help but imagine the ramifications must have felt huge. Two, similar to question one, what was it like when you learned that humans had walked on the moon? Both of these, the bomb and the moon, are things we take for granted now. But at the time, they must have been a massive paradigm shift. Can you share your thoughts? Many thanks for your time and for your service. One, it was a fantastic illustration of science. He says he wasn't scared about the bomb because people did not understand what the atomic bomb was. Two, very surprising illustration of science. He was in Mount Baker, Washington. He didn't watch it at the time, but the word got out. Don't drive faster than 35 miles per hour. Boy, it took forever to get home. The state made a law change. Save gasoline and avoid accidents. He heard about it later. Firstly, thanks for your service. What are the three things you learned in your life? Traveling and encountering the cruelness of World War II? What are those three advices you would give your grandchildren? Daughter, when you see something you don't understand, then use whatever research situation you have to find out more about it and how it can help you in your life. Also, how to find a beautiful blonde wife. What is the best joke you've heard? He says he has to think about it. The man upstairs is watching out for you, taking care of you. And he hasn't decided whether he wants to bring you upstairs or not. This was when he was at church with some pastors discussing his age, and one of the pastors came up with this zinger, and now he tells everyone it. How did you meet your wife? I'll ask him next time I see him. He will enjoy this one, I'm sure. She worked on the same floor that FDA was on, and I met her when I was just walking down the hall. We went to coffee a couple times to get better acquainted. Probably started dating her within the order for 5 or 6 months. How was life between retirement and 100 years old, and how did you fill these almost 40 years of life? Is boredom a problem? If so, how do you fight it? Well, let me tell you, he didn't even fully retire till 90-something. He loved working. live-to-work type of guy. Nowadays, he does a bunch of little projects around the house to help stave off boredom. But honestly, he would procrastinate all those a good bit and fill his time with TV and newspapers and the ever-present project of clearing the papers from the den at his kitchen table. This is the end of the video. Thank you guys for staying with me till the end. If you enjoyed watching this, you might as well watch these too.